Good afternoon. Thank you for watching Rundlii Gaming. So we're going to be trying to do another round of Hearthstone Battleground. So we're going to see what we have today and see what happens. Well, since I've never actually been able to run Mr. Pesticide, let's give it a go. Alright, so with this ability, I think it is one where we just want to try to speedrun through the tavern tiers as well. So because this gives us two, you have the coin plus the cell and that, we're probably going to do that. Because as soon as we can grab tier 6, and then activate these 3 times would be probably ideal. Oh, let's see what we get. Alright, same thing. Now we'll do 4. Then we'll grow the tavern tier 1 more time, and then we'll buy 2 minions. Then we'll just grow all the way up to 6 after that, hopefully. So hopefully their next batch would be something useful. Otherwise we're going to have to ram them into the next one after that and hope for the best. They're taking some damage there, which is fine. So, if we end up taking this later, I mean, we'd basically have a knight. My knight and taunt, I guess, might be the way to go. Or just grab the 2/5, just gets a little more sturdy, I guess. Yeah, because if we ran them again, it could be much worse. So in this case, we're going to grab the knight, and we'll grab... And ideally at this point, we could basically just keep hitting tavern tiers all the way up. Then hopefully this should give us enough survival to not take a ton of damage. He's on tier 2 right now. Which means he probably has a little bit bigger of a board state than we do. Which might be fine. Because we kind of want to let this guy die a few more times. Kind of start building up. Alright, so we at least reduced it down to 4 damage. Yeah, that being said, we'll kind of fall behind a little bit, which usually gives us some of the weaker opponents. Which is kind of sometimes my strategy, is basically get enough to where you're not just taking full damage every round, and you're kind of cutting it down, but not so... But, you know, I basically bring it down towards the bottom, which means you'll hopefully keep facing off with these easier opponents here. Because, like, if we get paired up with, like, the Sarah here again, that'll be a pretty much an easy match again as well. Kind of a freebie. Tides are always good. Yeah, that's why I mentioned. Like in this case, this hopefully should be a freebie round, because last time he had no minions. So unless he's gradually taking more damage, I'm assuming he doesn't have much. So coming out of this, we would be 6-star after this round, which means that we'll take a full hit from someone probably above, you know, the top 4. And then we'll start crafting demons at that point, or undead. Actually, doesn't have a board state now. Which is fine. I'm gonna take some damage on it. I was thinking that was just gonna be a straight freebie on that. But they can't one shot us next round, so I think we'll be fine. And that's kind of the downside sometimes with trying to be at the higher ranks, is a lot of times they'll be at a much lower tier level. Now, depending on your build, sometimes it's fine. A lot of these are juggling third and fourth tier. Fourth tier. And even juggling with, you know, board state versus tavern, I'll still able to hit 6, and I'm still on 5th, so I mean... It kind of works out, but so the style of play sometimes has pros and cons, because it'll be kind of like going down a real gradual downhill process, and then hope you don't hit the very bottom, you know, and somewhere you stay wise before you get there. So like in this case, this guy here, though he's been getting pummeled by pretty much everybody, hopefully we're at least roughly even. I'm going to assume he might actually beat me, but Hopefully mine won't be up by a while. Because at this point, then we're going to start crafting big undeads and stuff. Yeah, so pretty sure I'm losing this one, which is fine. Mean old dragon. Alright, so probably want to go the Eternal Night route. But Divine Shield and Reborn would actually be pretty nice. Like poison it. Oh yeah. I mean that's just, I don't know if there's a way to go around that one. So now that we're at 6, like he would be a good amount of tempo. And we could probably reroll once and then sell those two if something good comes out. Like he actually might not be bad. The downside is I have no one with taunt anymore, but it might be fine. Yeah, that'll be kind of our next big step, is basically giving quite possibly both of them taunt. Alright. Now we get to party. Alright, let's see what big demon we get this round. Because every round we get to pop another big. I mean, if we want to go for big one, this might be your best bet. Because, yeah, those are both kind of mediocre. Divine Shield might be, again, a good direction to take it. Alright, so. Oh yeah, there's the shield cannon, we should knock out. I mean, I guess we could go that direction. And at this point, basically stabilized on that hill. Now it's just a matter of climbing back up. And our last one. So, probably more eternal night enters when attacks destroyed. No, don't want to do that. I mean, why not? I was thinking about grabbing this one just to make him bigger, but we may not need him to do that. Well, that might just be a better alternative to that. So we'll grab this one. Let's make him a 15-15 just to keep him with some survival. This will give Taunt. And I think what I might do is taunt these guys so that because we might be able to just find some regular ones of these. Because if we find a couple regular ones of those, then we could just make an entire board of those. Can't build any new ones. So we kind of want to continue down this direction. We're going to start shielding every one of them. So I guess since they're taunting, let's go ahead and drop them in the land. We could make them 15-15, probably like Colossus, but I don't know if that would be super useful right now. A key would be a good choice. Again, I'll switch this Eternal Knight for one of the Eternal Summoners. And I think we can get rid of him too, once we get two more of the Eternal Summoner guys. Anyway, so at that point, anytime one of these four die, they'll just drop more Eternal Knights, and drop more Eternal Knights, and drop more Eternal Knights. So, of course, he's not being super useful because since they drop so many at once, I guess their reborns never actually trigger. I might actually get rid of one. Whenever we do get someone, we need to shield. Let's see what the strongest player currently brings at the moment. With the reclaimed souls, they should have pretty big creatures at the very least. Some pretty big undead. Yeah, so they're definitely larger, but we do have some tricks up our sleeve, which is nice. Get eliminated, which is good. But we can make a comeback on that. It might just take a little bit more. Mm-hmm. What undead do they have? They're actually not running any kind of undead that I want. This for that, this for that. As good as he is, we might actually go the direction of that. Because like at this point, I'm not even sure if we necessarily need the Baron, just because there's something so many at this point that may not entirely matter. Mm-hmm. Oh, I guess we already rotate that. We might actually be getting rid of this one. I'm gonna go and shield it. That way it dies quicker. And then, kinda let them all run through. That way, when these ones actually do reborn, hopefully there's space for them. God's sake, should we keep running into the reborns on these? That's kind of what we're trying to do, is get the reborn to trigger. So I took that one down too. Alright, so we're actually on the nemesis here. Because we have not. In fact, no one's actually beat them. I think they are still at their max health. Hopefully this one strikes first and then destroys himself on whatever big thing they have on their side, or they tap him out first. And at that point, those two will which gives us our two. More knights. Alright. So they went from undefeated until they met us again. I still don't have anything we necessarily want. I mean, we could try to battle cry this one out to see if we get something 6-starred, which might end up being one of those. But I'm not sure that we want one of those. Like, one option might be just to replace it with another Eternal. I'll explore that option. We're just basically throwing this one up there to give something 5/5. In this case, that guy. So according to this, the stats are definitely on our side. Like, this might be an option, but I think we would lose so much because we'd only get plus 16, plus 16, because all of those would get plus 4, plus 4. But then we would lose a 48, 45. Like, this isn't super beneficial because it's a very minor bonus. Through again. So this round still favors us. There's roughly a 25% chance that I think we could still lose. Swung it out. They went from undefeated until they met us, and then we just took them completely out. So, that was creating your own undead. Like I said, they're pretty much a big powerhouse for an ability. And you can make some pretty uniquely powerful stuff. But otherwise, thank you for watching Rundlii Gaming. Yeah, have a good day.